ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं कर्वावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the compound Palmer ganglion. This is a condition which affects the flexor tendons of the fingers, mainly the ulnar bursa. It is usually due to the tuberculosis, though rheumatoid arthritis may also be a cause. The term compound Palmer ganglion is derived from the swelling one above and below the flexor retinaculum. Now here the endothelial lining of the sheath is substituted by the granulation tissue containing the miliary tubercles. The presence of melanocyte bodies is the hallmark of this condition. Effusion may be seen and in the late stages the tendon may rupture. Now regarding the melanocyte bodies, let us have some quick facts. One, it is a hallmark of the compound Palmer ganglion. Second, it resembles grains of boiled sago. Now you can see in this particular picture two bowls are seen. In the first bowl, what is there is a unboiled sago grains, and in the second ball, the black ball, that is a boiled sago. Now you can just compare the boiled sago with the melanocytes seen in this dissection. Now the melanocyte gives rise to a soft coarse crepitations, and they are made up of the fibrin, cellular debris and occasionally tuberculous bacilli. As far as the clinical feature of the compound Palmer ganglion is concerned, those affected with this condition, they are usually less than 40 years of age, and the chief complaint is always a swelling, not the pain. Pain is not a feature. An hourglass swelling with a cross fluctuation may be noted. There may be features of median nerve compression, but there is definitive evidence of the wasting of hand and forearm muscles. Now why forearm muscle wastings? As I told you, mostly the etiology remains tuberculosis in origin. And whenever there is a tuberculosis infection, it is a hallmark of tuberculosis infection that there is a disproportionate excessive muscle wasting. Investigation-wise, routine laboratory test, plain x-rays of the wrist and hand, biopsy, etc. are some of the recommended investigations. And the treatment-wise, as you all know that we have got very effective anti-tuberculous chemotherapy treatment available. So, in cases of compound Palmer ganglion, anti-tubercular treatment, splinting of the forearm, and exercise in the late stage, if it is all due to the tuberculosis, is sufficient. Whereas in case of it being a rheumatoid origin, then one may need to do a complete excision of the inflamed synovial sheaths, and that is the treatment of choice in compound Palmer ganglion of the rheumatoid etiology. With this, thank you very much for your patient listening. Do visit to my YouTube channel, watch other YouTube videos, subscribe it, like it and share it. Thank you very much.